Binding. Now we got just some simple stuff yet. See if I can drop the head a bit more. She's always quite up. We keep a simple trot. I don't want anything fancy. Just simple. Prepare the bending here. Put my outside leg on. Drop her head a bit more. Control the stride. That was better. Now she's also more at ease there. I always practice my bending also on a straight line to see if I can control my line with the bending and without bending. It's a preparation for me, you know, to go into a nice half pass. So if I have this bending and she's soft on the inside like this, then I only have to put my outside leg on to get her into a half pass. Start with bending, outside leg on. There we go. This was a preparation for my canter pirouette and still to improve my canter. So I make the canter transition with a bit of bend that the inside hind leg is still stepping under the body, and I can soften the inside rein. And I stay on the big circle. I try to speed up a bit and slow down. And speed up again and slow down. And after slowing down, I also want to give her self-carriage. She has to carry herself. I do not want to carry her. Sometimes I have to keep my hands on a bit, but if I do that too long, it means that I hold her. And as long as I hold her, it's not self-carriage, real self-carriage. So bring the hind legs to the outside a bit for a change. Try to keep the contact on two reins, that she's not tilting her head. And I still want to try to stretch that neck. Okay, hind legs in again. And then we're gonna make a small canter pirouette. So bring her back more. Now we're gonna turn. Out onto a working pirouette with the hind legs to the inside, and then I want to be able to go back to walk with the hind legs under. That was good, and I can still give